Hi friends, welcome back to my kitchen. Today we will see a very traditional recipe, a Tiffin recipe rather. I had request for this recipe, so I thought of posting it today. It is called Usili upma. I don't know how many of you would have heard this name. It is called Usili upma. It's a proper traditional Brahmin Tiffin. If you browse for this recipe, you can come across different varieties of recipe. Some recipes, you know, that includes onion with moong dal and all that. So if you mix onion with moong dal and rice, it will taste like moong dal khichdi. It is something close to that. But proper way of preparing traditional Usili upma is quite different. I will show you how to prepare that. It is a recipe that includes moong dal and rice. It is just like pongal, but it is made in a very different way. Alright, let's go to the kitchen and see how to prepare that today. Now I have spread out the ingredients needed for this Usili upma. This is raw rice, approximately 1.5 cup of raw rice I have taken. Then this is moong dal. I have taken about less than 1/2 cup, you know. Well, this is a ratio that you use for pongal. You know, you take 1 cup of rice and 1/4 cup of moong dal for pongal. So that's the proper ratio you have to take for this also. But the preparation is a little different. And here I have spread out red chilies. Little bit of salt to taste. This is compound asafoetida and this is curry leaves. Tempering I will tell you as and when I do it. Okay. Now I have heated a kadai here. First procedure is you have to fry the rice separately and moong dal separately for this upma. That will give you a good flavor and taste, an added taste. Now before adding this into the kadai, make sure you wash the rice and moong dal separately and then add it to the kadai and fry till you get a little bit of smell out of it. A good smell arises after you fry for a little while. So do that. After frying for about 5 minutes, you get good aroma out of the rice and that's the right stage to remove it. Now in the same kadai, I'm adding washed moong dal. You just have to dry roast both the dal and rice. Don't add oil and fry it. This is just to enhance this taste. So it's sufficient if you dry roast both the ingredients. Now dal is getting roasted. This moong dal is done. I'm getting good aroma out of it. So I'm transferring it to a plate now. While mentioning the ingredients, I didn't tell about the oil. I thought of mentioning it while tempering. So I have taken a cooker and added 2 to 3 tablespoons of oil and that is sufficient in the cooker. Now I'll go with the tempering now. Please note, I'm adding tempering one by one. Just 1 tablespoon of mustard. Let it crackle. Then after that, add 2 tablespoons of urad dal, then add about 4 tablespoons of chenna dal, harala parappu, that's what you tell in Tamil. This has to be a little more in this upma, that will give you good taste. Add red chilies, break them and add it inside. Then add curry leaves. And the compound asafoetida inside. Now then let it turn little golden brown, so inside will end. After it turns little golden brown, add water little by little. Water measure is just like pongal. 1 cup, 4 glasses of water. That's the measure you add for pongal. So that will be the same measure for this upma also. Now you can see the water is boiling inside, so that's the stage you have to add salt that is needed for the upma. Now lower the flame. After adding salt, add the other ingredients too. Add rice and moong dal. After adding rice, add in the moong dal also.
Then give it a proper mix before closing the lid. And close the lid and leave for 5 whistles. Close the lid and I have closed the lid and added the whistle also. Now this is done. The whistle has come. I left for 5 whistles. That is done and I have opened the cooker. This usli upma is done. See, it's so lovely to see. If you want it little smashy, you can add even more little water, even more 1 or 2 cups of it and then mix it. Even now if you mix it, it will get little smashy like over. Now this usli upma is ready. I am serving it today with coconut togayal. You can serve it with sambar, gochu or coconut chutney, anything you prefer to, or even sambar will go well with this, just like pongal. So just try this at home. And one thing I would like to say is, this is the traditional way to prepare usli upma. I have seen my granny prepare it this way, so I am sure this is the traditional way. Just try it at your home and I am sure you will love this recipe.
Now in my kitchen, I showed you how to prepare this usli upma. Try it at your home, a traditional, very tasty recipe. Do let me know if you liked it. Please keep supporting me and following my recipes. Subscribe my channel. Do support me as usual. Thank you so much, friends. Bye for now.